Welcome to Clarke Stadium. What a beautiful night for a game in Alberta's capital. Around about 24 degrees at the moment. Gorgeous weather for FC Edmonton against Rayo OKC tonight. The Eddies back in action after the game against Miami, where a long unbeaten run came to an end, but they'll hope to get another one going tonight against Rayo, who've been in a little bit of turmoil in their season in the NASL. The game tonight presented by Oodle Noodle, and we are live on Facebook tonight for this matchup. Good evening, I'm Gareth Hampshire alongside Steve Sandor. Still all to play for the Eddies tonight, Steve, and they can close the gap on New York if they get back to winning ways.
I'm sure everyone around FC Edmonton is disappointed with Sunday's result, and the thing that you want as a player or as a coach or anyone involved in a club is that chance to get right back and play again to get that taste out of your mouth.
Let's bring in the coach that Steve talked about there, Colin Miller, with us on the pitch. Colin, what are you going for tonight? A couple of changes I'm hearing from you after the defeat on Sunday.
Yes, we're going for 3 points, of course. Gareth, I know it was a daft question, but we've changed it up a little bit. Well, there's three changes, actually. Daryl Fordyce is now fit and available for selection, so he starts. Christian Rodales will come in as a holding midfield player, and Carson Smith gets another start here. I just felt that Pap Diakite needed a couple of days away from it in terms of not overthinking what's happened over the last little while. So he's on the bench tonight, and he's been a big part of our club and our success so far this season, and will continue to be a big part of our club and our success moving forward. But I just feel now and again with players you need to bring them out of situations, and Big Carson's been doing very well in training and deserves his chance here tonight, so fingers crossed it works.
And some uncharacteristic defensive slip-ups have cost you, which has not been the case. You've conceded the least goal, the best defence in the league. What kind of response, what have you been talking to the players about tonight?
I actually pulled all eight defenders that we have in the squad aside at the end of training yesterday and said, guys, this is, you know, we've got to cut out these lapses of concentration. It's not a lack of ability, it's just a lapse of concentration. And the last four goals the Eddies have given up have been very far away from the standard that we've set for the most part this season. These types of goals are going back to the spring season of last year when it was a comedy of errors show every game. But we get back to the basics, and I said that to the lads. I want to see us defending as defenders first and foremost, and get back to those certain standards and simplifying everything that we do, because between a goalkeeper and a back four, that's the rock that the team is built on. And if the back four are on a bit of a wobble, then it can spread throughout the team, because the team played very well on Sunday. We didn't deserve to get beat. I actually thought we deserved to win the game. Matt at one stage was going to get arrested for loitering in the second half there against Miami because he didn't have anything to do. So we have to get back to those standards defensively, and if we do that, then it's going to give us a chance to move forward and win some more games.
Okay, good luck tonight, Colin.
Thanks very much.
Colin Miller joining us, hoping for a solid back four, and Carsten Smith coming in to replace Pap Diakite after that mistake on Sunday against Miami. Let's look back at the highlights from that game.
And there we see Nick Ledgerwood with a volleyed attempt that was tipped over by Vega. And then Ben Fisk hits the bar. And then Nico DiBiase with the giveaway. And Colin Miller was just talking about the giveaways. Dario Svitinic deposits the ball into an empty goal. FC Edmonton were playing into the win, but still, you can't give the ball away like that. And then Pap Diakite in the second half misjudges a goal kick, allows it to get behind easily for Ranella to put it into the net to make it 2-0 Miami. Two very poor self-inflicted goals from FC Edmonton that cost him the game on Sunday.
Not the kinds of errors we're used to seeing, so a bit of a change. Diakite is out and Carsten Smith is in, and Christian Rodales also gets a start today for FC Edmonton against Rayo OKC. It'll be the 100th performance, the 100th appearance for Daryl Fordyce, the club's all-time leading goal scorer. We've just heard from Colin Miller. He is fit to play and will take his place in the team. Albert Watson's already made 100 caps, and just beginning his FC Edmonton career is Ben Fisk, and we talked to the both of them before this game.
It was a good win against Jacksonville, 1-0. So we know they're tough. They've got good players. They've got you know, Samaras, they've got Botan, they've good players all over the field. They've got players that can change a game just on a whim, and that's what we'll have to guard against. But we know if we're up to our standards that we've set this year, that we'll be okay. And the confidence is still with the guys. The confidence is still high. We just need to help the boys out in front of us and cut out the stupid mistakes.
All good. I felt confident. I was connecting well with the teammates, so the only thing missing was the result. It gives us a chance to make up for the loss. You know, I thought the game, apart from the two goals we gave away, we played pretty well. So I think the whole team's eager to get back on the field and make up for that. I think even coming off the bench the last few games, I've had a couple shots that have been close. So, you know, I'm getting in the right areas and stuff. So I think I'll get that little luck on my side hopefully soon and get that first goal.
Let's hope he does. He's been having his shooting boots on, just things not coming off for him. But back in the mix again tonight as the Eddies take on Rayo OKC, and 3 points would do them the world of good in the standings as they try and trace down the New York Cosmos in first place. And this is the fall standings, and when you look at the combined, this game in hand could be very important for them.
Yeah, and I know Colin Miller was just telling us off camera before that they're not really thinking about the New York Cosmos game on Saturday, but they really need to get those 6 points now in those two games in hand that they have to pull even and to get close again in that overall race. FC Edmonton look very, very good for a playoff position. That'd be one of the four playoff teams at the end of the year. But what they really want is to make sure they get a home game. And for that, they're going to need to get past the Cosmos.
That'd be a big advantage later in the fall. The Eddies playing at home, that's what they're shooting for. And the road to that begins tonight against Rayo OKC as they try and begin another unbeaten run after the last one ended on Sunday. Let's look at the keys to the game tonight with Steve.
All right, the first one is those early game meltdowns. We talked about the last two games against Ottawa and against Miami. Early in the game in both situations, the Eddies put themselves down. Here we see Nico DiBiase with just an unforced error, holding onto the ball, lingering on the ball, no one communicating to him that he's got to get that ball out of trouble. And they basically gift wrap a goal for Miami. And there we see the mistake from Pop Diakite later in the game. But early in the game against Ottawa as well, and I'm going back in time a little bit as we see that second goal with Diakite gave up. Diakite made a miscue that led to Thomas Stewart's opening goal in the first couple of minutes of that game, where he miskicked the ball in his own penalty area. So they've got to clean that up and get that out of their game. The second key is they got to shoot the ball. You know, this is a team that has been struggling to score. They win by defense. But they had some opportunities that they created when they're willing to take shots and not look for the perfect play. Here we see Ben Fisk hitting it off the bar. I know off his foot he'd said, I thought I'd scored. But with the wind and such, just swerved around and went off the bar. But they need more chances like that. Ben Fisk was shooting from outside, tested the goalie a couple of times as well. Nick Ledgerwood did that in last game. They need to see more of that. When you shoot that 20-yard ball, you open things up inside later because defenses have got to respect that.
So the Eddies hoping that Fisk can maybe hit the target tonight. Certainly getting a run in the team now and a chance to try and break his duck and get that goal. And if he does, then you get the feeling that he'll really get his confidence.
Ben Fisk, right so far when we've seen him play, he's had that ability to sort of make you feel like he's going to do something special. He's had the ability to shuffle the ball within his feet, take on defenders, and you can see why he was brought in. Player who was playing in Spain last year, Canadian player brought in, and you know there's a lot of people pretty excited when they heard that Ben Fisk had signed with FC Edmonton, and I think we're starting to see more and more of what he can do, and he can electrify a game.
Let's look out for his form again tonight. Ben Fisk in the lineup, FC Edmonton against Rayo OKC. We are live on Facebook tonight. Thanks for joining the broadcast, and the kickoff is coming up next.
Onside.
beautifully finished. A clinical strike. Far post, and there's the header, and there's the goal for Kiakate. Getting his head on that one, and the Eddies are up 2-1. Nice atmosphere inside Clarke Stadium on this gorgeous night for a game of football. FC Edmonton against Rayo OKC. The players just shaking hands in the center of the pitch there as the mascots run off and we get ready, set for kickoff in this important matchup for FC Edmonton, and one in which coach Colin Miller has decided to make a couple of changes in this game today. Game presented today by Oodle Noodle. And we are live on Facebook, broadcasting from Alberta's capital tonight. Let's take a look at the starting lineups, beginning with FC Edmonton. And Matt Van Okel in goal, still been in top form for the Eddies. Right back, Sean Nicklaw. Eckersley at left back. The captain, Albert Watson, in the middle of defense. And that's the big change. Carsten Smith coming in for Diakite, who is dropped. DiBiase also left out. Rodalis takes his spot in the midfield, alongside Ledgerwood, and on the right wing, Niasse, Fisk on the left, who's looked impressive. Darryl Fordyce making his 100th appearance, just got a presentation from the club owner, Tom Fath, and he'll just be behind Tomi Amiobi, the lone striker for Edmonton tonight. Rayo OKC, Fernandez in goal, back four of Danso, Kimura, Ibiaga, and Hernandez, Yuma, Chavez, Boateng the captain, and Menjivar. Billy Forbes just behind Samaras, who's been greeted by a number of Celtic and Greece supporters, even wearing the shirts, wanting their photo taken with Samaras. There, the skippers coming together for the coin toss in the middle of the park, and there is Ben Fisk, and he'll hope that he can just make a bit of a difference for the Eddies this evening and get the right bounces and finally get on the score sheet. So close so far for FC Edmonton, who will be attacking the goal to our right. And Rayo OKC, the team in the white with the red diagonal stripes across the shorts. And there are the goalies, Matt Van Okel and Daniel Fernandez in goal for Rayo.
Daniel Fernandez is having a homecoming today. I mean, he's a Portuguese national goalkeeper, but born in Edmonton. He used to play for the Canadian under-20s before he made the switch. And he did has played with the Portuguese national side, actually went to the World Cup in 2010 with Portugal, where he was a backup keeper. But he comes from this area. He also lived in Vancouver before moving to Europe, and now he's back in North America. But this is a homecoming for him.
Great story, Steve. And he's going to know all about this pitch then. And you can see he's got the baseball cap there with him because the sun is very bright. You may not need it in that goal in the first half, shielded by the stadium stands as the players huddle in the middle and get ready for this one. A big one, this, for the Eddies. A game they're expected to win, but it's never that easy. And they do want to get back to winning ways to put that pressure back on New York. This is one of the games in hand that Edmonton have.
You can bet with all the Celtic shirts. And I mean, you're seeing there's actually a Celtic supporter section that showed up to see Georgios Samaras today. A solid Rangers man like Colin Miller must love seeing all the green and white hoops in the stadium tonight.
Just across from us, you can see them on the pitch there as they line up just inside the Eddies' half in the stand across from us. And we're underway, and Samaras getting a touch there, but it's taken away from him Charging run forward from Ledgerwood. Slips it out wide to Fisk. Fisk tries to dart in onto his right boot. His cross is headed away. And Rayo will scramble it clear. And we know that Billy Forbes can be dangerous in these positions, especially on that left side. And he's going to strike a boot on that shot. Tried to trickle it into the corner, but Van Okel gets down and makes the save low to his right.
And you know Billy Forbes, as you said, Gareth, is a player who's tormented FC Edmonton in the past. As a player with San Antonio Scorpions, has had several good games, especially here in this stadium. He's had a couple of days to remember. So someone that I'm sure FC Edmonton is very aware of.
Forbes getting the first shot on target, but Van Okel getting down to make the save. And the Eddies will have a chance to test Fernandez here. The first free kick of the match from them, almost on the edge of the penalty area.
Eddie's just put the baseball cap on as he's getting ready to see this kick. He just slipped it on, so now he's wearing the cap. And yeah, the sun is, this time of year, it's pretty low in the sky at this time of night, just after 7 o'clock. And it's going to cast some long shadows and have some glare that both the keepers are going to have to deal with before it gets underneath the stands.
Just after 7 p.m., but conditions fantastic. Still 22 degrees in Edmonton at the moment, as Daryl Fordyce stands over this ball with Eckersley. Fordyce whips it around the wall. He went very close, and I think that one just struck the outside of the post as it went wide, and just tried to find the angle around the wall and almost caught Fernandez unawares. He was scrambling over there, probably had it covered, but it wasn't a bad try.
Yeah, I think he probably would have got there. It would have been close. But yeah, I think everyone was expecting Fordyce to maybe try to go the other way around the wall, and he slipped it around on the near post side, trying to see if he catch the keeper napping. Good attempt.
Tackled by Ledgerwood, putting the pressure on. Rayo and the Eddies have got themselves a throw in. Fisk finding Amiobi. Battling for it in the penalty area, but Rayo will get it clear. Eckersley taking it back, and Edmonton dominating possession in the first 3 minutes. Inside his marker there and gets another free kick for FC Edmonton.
There's Ryan Byers there on the challenge. And interesting to see both these teams play Sunday, so they're both on extremely short weeks. Edmonton only had time for one training session yesterday, and Rayo played Sunday night and then had to make the trip all the way up to Edmonton. So we'll see. That's really going to affect their legs. Wonder if they're going to try to slow the pace down and be conservative, because they are coming off a very, very short week and a lot of travel on it.
Straight after this game, the Eddies are flying to New York at 6 a.m. tomorrow morning. So the travel schedule is going to be tough for Edmonton as well, that game on Saturday.
I think Colin Miller said the coaches are, what, they begin their carpool at 3 in the morning?
It's going to be an early start.
I wonder if they even get to bed tonight. Maybe they just do what I would do, which is to stay up. Sleep on the plane.
Watch a bit more football, maybe. Free kick here for the Eddies. Rodala's over it, getting a start back in the team today. He's whipped this one very deep to the far post, and Fernandez got a hand on that one, and Smith was challenging him for it, and he's accusing him of backing in. But in any event, the whistle had gone.
I think from where Fernandez is taking it, like, I thought he was setting it back there, that it was given as a free kick. It's really 6 of 1, half dozen of the other. But Edmonton with some good early pressure. They've been pressing that back line, trying to create turnovers, really trying to take space away. And I think, again, maybe the expectation might be Samaras looks like he's the lone striker out there, that OKC is going to pack the back, pack the midfield, and sit back a bit. I think Edmonton's looking to attack that. Certainly looks like a very conservative setup from Rayo OKC right now. And you can see Samaras is out there by his lonesome.
A the number of nine, Samaras, and supported by Forbes, who is number seven for Rayo OKC. Goes Carsten Smith, wins a header, and then looped up in the air by Ledgerwood. Amiobi trying to get a touch on that one and control it, and he finds support from Nyasi, who's going to try and make a break down the right wing and gets chopped down by Boateng. Not too much doubt about that. Thing.
Dave Gantar has been calling a few fouls in favor of FC Edmonton as Billy Forbes is encroaching there. And we see the foul, Derek Boateng. And I think this will be Eckersley on the left foot swinging this in. Some big bodies in there for FC Edmonton. Amiobi, Watson, Carsten Smith is up there.
The ball whipped in by Eckersley, maybe just a fraction low and headed away. Smith chips this one over the top, might drop for Watson on the edge of the area, but Boateng is there to try to redeem himself. Great little turn by Ledgerwood, who then flicks it over the top himself. It's headed back, though, well to his goalkeeper by Hernandez to Fernandez, who will boot it clear for Ryan.
Ledgerwood's been very, very active. He's really come up, played more of an offensive role. He was the best player for Canada last week in their win over El Salvador. And I think it's just increased his confidence. Even though Canada was eliminated from World Cup qualifying, his individual performance in that game came very close to scoring against Miami early on in that game, the first couple of minutes with the great volley.
Tipped over the top by the goalkeeper for Miami, who played very well for them. Here by Boateng, who slips the ball down the left-hand side, and here's Billy Forbes again. Forbes dangerous when he runs at players. He's to the edge of the penalty area. Just dropped for him again there. It's skied up into the air, and Van Okel makes the claim, but Forbes already making himself a bit of a menace in that box. Fisk has played a very nice pass up the left-hand side. Eckersley's just going to whip that one in first time, but a bit too much strength on it for Ledgerwood to make it there.
And again, you see Nick Ledgerwood getting forward again, really pushing up today. Really a far more advanced. And with Christian Rodales now playing back there, we're in that holding midfield position. Ledgerwood really be giving a lot more freedom of the pitch to be more of that attacking midfield kind of player, and he seems to be relishing that role.
Been working on that with Colin Miller, who feels that he's got a goal in him if he gets a chance.
He's got a couple in the fall season. Scored a big one against New York Cosmos a few weeks ago.
Yeah, and hoping to add to that tally and got more of a chance to get forward, it seems, with the way they've been playing with Rodales or Diabiasi back there. Rodales, and he's just going to feed that one wide to Fordyce, who's quite deep here. Samaras all the way to the halfway line. Nias is the one who makes the tackle. Fordyce pushing it through, but it's going to run all the way through to Fernandez.
George Samaras' fan club's not going to be too happy. The first couple of touches he's had, he's giving away the ball. Last time there was a case of him trying to take on too many players and not getting rid of it.
Thank you. bouncing around there. It's somebody wants to get it on the ground. Viaga does and finds Hernandez left back position. Takes a touch, but he's well tackled by Saini Niasse. Ledgerwood is holding Boateng, who wins a free kick.
See, though, Rayo OKC is playing very, very compact. Eight players very close to each other, very tight. Forbes is given some freedom to go up the wings, and Samaras up top as the striker. But the other eight are very tight. They're really trying to take away all the space. And even on the attacking-wise, they're being very conservative, really not wanting to give Edmonton anything on the counter or give the ball away or put themselves in a bad situation where if they do give the ball away, they've got the shape to deal with it.
Makes a good break forward there. Still going, he's got a bit too much room, finally falls over, and the Eddies have got the ball back. Top aiming at Billy Forbes, headed out by Nick Law. It's going to be a throw-in. Fordyce penalized for a foul as he took that ball from the throw-in off Boateng.
Byers is standing over this. Moses Hernandez as well. Dave Gantar is pretty emphatic with the magic spray.
Yeah, and Niasse just shaking it off his boots there. Free kick delivered low. It's a poor one. And very easily cleared by Edmonton. Hernandez has come all the way out of his goal to retrieve that one. He could have put his team under a bit of pressure here. Ledgerwood ruled to be offside. I'm not sure about that. Looked very, very tight.
I thought Byers had already established and was behind him by the time Niasse played that ball. I thought Ledgerwood was okay, but linesman didn't agree. But Fernandez, risky game there. Almost gave it away to Ledgerwood. Ledgerwood got a bit of a touch on the ball the first, and then gave it away to Niasse.
He's clearly onside there.
He's clearly onside. And I think Colin Miller just saw it on the big screen. And he's giving the linesman the look like, look at that on the big screen. You tell me how that's offside. You can see Colin Miller's reaction there.
Felt hard done by Amiobi's ruled out goal in Sunday's game that he believed that was an incorrect decision as well. It was very, very tight. Difficult to see on the cameras, but Edmonton felt that that should have been given. And there is Amiobi, infield to Niasse. Takes another touch. He's got support here from Fisk, who strikes and hits the post again. And there's the rebound shot by Ledgerwood, and that one's gone over the top. And it seems like the goalposts are magnetized whenever Fisk is shooting.
It's harder to hit the post, isn't it? This should be worth more. But Fisk with a good strike here. Great play by Niasse, though, to square that ball to him. And Fisk just snicks it through the defender's legs. And then Ledgerwood has a look. Two Canadians getting very, very close. But Edmonton, a very, very bright start to this game. considering how they started their last two games, this is much, much better. I think Colin Miller's got to be pleased. They've created some scoring chances.
Yeah, this is the kind of response he was looking for, and maybe a tad unfortunate not to be in front. Forbes at the other end making a good run. Nick Law taking the ball away from him. Forbes thought that he should have had a corner kick. It wasn't given. But Rayo have got the ball back until Fordyce takes it away and then gets taken down. It's a free kick.
Javar making sure he got enough of Fordyce to stop that break from happening. Edmonton's looked good, though, going forward. I really like Ledgerwood in this advanced position. I think he's been very, very effective so far, and it's really bothered OKC. I like where he's playing. I like this move by Colin Miller to have him so far up in the attack.
Yeah, he's quite a bit further forward than we've seen him before. And in fact, if anything, Darryl Fordyce playing a deeper role today.
Yeah, and right now what I've seen from Nick Ledgerwood has been very effective. He's really he's helped create a couple of turnovers. He's had a couple of looks at goal. Yeah, you know, for Ben Fisk as well, it's going to come. He's creating the chances. He's getting good shots on goal. You just got to tell him to keep doing what he's doing.
In the post again, as he did on Sunday. Well, that was the crossbar, but rattled the whole frame of the goal. Danso striking a long ball forward. And Niasse nods that one back to Nick Law. And they try and play their way out of trouble, and that's nicely done. Nick Law still in possession, back to Niasse. He won't get to that, even with his pace. And it's a throw-in.
It's been a lively first 17, 18 minutes, though. Games have played at a good pace. Certainly it's a beautiful night to play. There's no wind at all. Not like Sunday.
Yeah, it was a little bit like a wind tunnel in here on Sunday. 40 kilometer winds, gusts, and very difficult conditions for the players. This is gorgeous. People sitting in t-shirts today. They were in winter parkas on Sunday.
Yeah, I think we had our winter jackets on while we were doing the game on Sunday.
Yeah. Manjivar for Rayo. Samaras the target for that ball, and he brings it down. Tries the cutback. Watson will get there. Drives it up the left-hand side. Amiobi's chasing it down. It'll go back across the back four. Looking for the long pass to Niasse. Didn't work out, but he's picked out Fordyce here, who threads one through the middle. And again, that just doesn't find the intended target of Ledger. Does well there. Niasse feeds it to Rodales, who switches play quickly with a pass to Eckersley. Eckersley, just a short little ball to Fisk, and now Fordyce tries to get Eckersley on the overlap. Gave him a little too much to do there, sold him a bit short, and shoots and loses possession. Rodales has just turned one around the corner there, and Nicola has done extremely well to keep that one in, sliding for it.
You can just see the way Edmonton's pressuring every time Oklahoma City has the ball. Christian Rodales running about 20 yards trying to push to pressure a ball carrier there. Ledgerwood coming up, Ben Fisk coming up. They're really wanting to push the tempo, and I think they know that this is an Oklahoma City team that played Sunday night. And yes, Edmonton played Sunday afternoon, but they didn't have to travel. And it's a big difference.
Yeah, it looks like Edmonton winning a lot of the 50-50 challenges so far. Eckersley again on the left-hand side. He's put one in the area. Danso clears. Boateng trying to feed this one over the top for Billy Forbes, but he's offside.
There's lots of hands that went up in the crowd as well, too. A lot of assistant linesmen out there in the stands. This is the third time the two teams have played this year. So this will be their final meeting, but the first one at Edmonton. The first two were in Yukon, Oklahoma. Which makes you wonder if there's an Oklahoma in the Yukon. But both games ended in draws. Gustavo Salguero scored maybe the nicest FC Edmonton goal of the year with a rocket late in the game in Oklahoma. Last time these two teams played at the start of the fall season, 1-1 draw.
Boateng riding the challenge of Fordyce there. Cross aimed at Samaras, that Watson heads away. Another throw in. Well, Niasse does well. He's stolen that one. Hernandez, but Hernandez recovering.
Again, that's that pressure we've been talking about. Eddie's just not wanting to give any of the Rayo players any kind of time on the ball whatsoever. And there we saw it from Niasse, almost picking the pocket of Hernandez. And Oklahoma City's going to have to react to this by playing the ball quicker, by having some more 1-2, some more triangles. Players just can't be lingering on the ball, waiting for something to happen.
The Oklahoma coach just turning the ball back to the Eddies there. Gerard Neuse, who replaced Alan Marcina. A few changes at the time. They've had their problems, have Rayo OKC.
Yeah, obviously, we all know around the league about some of the issues that they've had now with Rayo Vallecano coming in, bringing in, and the changes in the front office. Rayo Vallecano, one of the owners of the team, the Spanish club. Gerard Neuse brought in after Alan Marcina, the Canadian coach, resigned after a lot of changes in the front office. And obviously, some more turmoil that went on, including some interesting things, dispute over the turf on that field in Yukon, Oklahoma, with owners disputing over who actually owned that turf.
Naniobe getting the ball under control on the edge of the area. Fisk shot deflected, it drops to Eckersley. Eckersley puts in the cross. Fisk was wanting another cutback. The cross is headed away. It's a good bit of defending there by Rayo as they begin a counter-attack. Here's Samaras. Now Boateng. But the flag up again, so a couple of times that Rayo have been undone by the offside trap. Chavez did excellent to bring the ball out of defense, but he was the one who, in fact, then drifted into an offside position.
I have to say, I really like the pace this game is being played at, though. The whole team's getting on with it pretty quickly. He's being very compact, daring FC Edmonton to try something. It's well offside by Niasse.
Hernandez with a free kick. Watson heading it away. Ledgerwood is chasing it. Done well to get there, tries to carry it on.
I have to say, it's a foul there on Niasse, but Moises Hernandez has got to be a lot more aware of what's happening around. It's a couple of times now where Edmonton players have picked his pocket because he's just waited. He's watching the ball, waiting for it to come to him. And Edmonton players are coming at him hard, looking to turn the ball over. That time, Ledgerwood beats him to a ball in the air that Moises Hernandez should win easily. He's got to be more aware. He's got to get help from his teammates as well. But it looks like Edmonton's isolated him. And they want him to get, they're seeing him as an opportunity to give the ball away.
Hernandez this time playing an accurate pass to Boateng, and Forbes cutting inside from the left. Billy Forbes finds Menjivar in the area, but it kind of broke down. And Eckersley tries to link up with Fisk, doesn't get the return ball, it's a throw in. Still 0-0 between FC Edmonton and Rayo OKC, 26 minutes on the clock. Channel for Niasse. Niasse gets to the byline, puts in the cross and wins a corner for Edmonton.
Eckersley going to take it. Big bodies for FC Edmonton. Everyone except for Rodalis and Nicklaw is up in the box. Niasse and Ledgerwood playing, coming in from very deep positions.
And Fernandez getting a right hand on it and doing enough. It drops for Rodalis, takes a touch and then drills a shot. And that was a super effort and an outstanding save by Fernandez.
That is an outstanding save by Daniel Fernandez. We saw that, like, he had bodies in front of him. It would have been hard for him to pick this one up. He's got a whole screen of bodies and picks that up late and gets a strong hand to it. I thought Rodalis would have thought he'd scored there. It was an excellent strike, but an even better save from the Rayo OKC keeper. Highlight reel stuff there from Daniel Fernandez and the Rayo OKC goal.
Yes, he's been put on this corner from the left wing, and he's driven it into the near post, and it's... headed away well by Rayo OKC, but that's the closest we've come. Good strike by Rodalis, an excellent stop though. I mean, that was headed for the corner, swerving a little bit. He got down low right by the post there to make that save.
That was a national team keeper showing his ability there. Because he didn't get a chance to see that until very late. There was a lot of bodies in front of him. And Rodalis absolutely hammered that shot. I mean, it was perfectly placed too, like just inside the post. You couldn't walk and put the ball in any better spot. If you thought, I'm gonna put this there off my foot.
Edmonton have hit the post with Fisk, and Rodalis has forced a fabulous save from Fernandez, but still no goals in this match yet. Get the feeling a goal will force Rayo to come out and play a little bit more. Referee saw nothing wrong with that push on Boateng, but then he did later. Singtu will be okay with it in the beginning, and Rodalis just bundled him over, saw it as shoulder to shoulder, but then took another look at it and awarded the free kick.
Yeah, it took Dave Gantar a second or two to think about this one. But Christian Rodalis does extend the arm when he pushes Boateng there. I think it's the most important thing is the right call gets made in the end. I think in that case, Rodalis did extend the arm. I think shoulder to shoulder might be a little bit of a stretch.
And in fact, when the free kick was given, Christian Rodalis didn't actually complain about it. So that tells you something.
I think it was more just why it takes long to make that call. Because it wasn't like you're waiting for an advantage. Edmonton had the ball.
Yuma is going to take this free kick. And it's chipped up into the penalty area. And flipped across the face of goal. Could have been more dangerous there by Hernandez, but in the end, it's a goal kick. Cordicea trying to begin an Edmonton attack. Slightly risky pass back there by Christian Rodales to put Carsten Smith in trouble, but Smith, bundled over by Samaras, has a free kick anyway.
I think if you're Edmonton, you just got to be patient. You got to think, just keep going with this game plan. We've created some very good scoring chances. We're unlucky not to be ahead. And we just got to keep doing what we're doing. There's been some very good things they've done in the final third. I talked off the top of the show about how they just have to shoot, and they've done that. There's been some very good attempts from that have really tested the keeper. I just think if you keep doing that, no matter how good the keeper is, it's eventually going to pay off for you.
Well, this is the second very good goalkeeper that the Eddies are running into in consecutive games. Vega was excellent on Sunday for Miami.
He was man of the match for me. And I was all...
Forbes there just trying his luck with a cross shot, but again, it runs wide.
That's an excellent ball from Billy Forbes. Player that we just mentioned earlier has given FC Edmonton fits in the past. Gets outside of Sean Nicola and drags a wonderful ball right across the goal and just misses Georgia Samaras by a couple of feet. You think if Georgia Samaras hits the deck and stretches out for that, maybe does he get on the end of that?
At the other end, it's Fisk on the left side. Tries to move in onto his right foot again. Delivers the cross to the far post and just doesn't find an Eddie's player, and it's gone.
That Forbes cross, I was thinking there's a couple of OKC players in the area there. It wasn't just Samaras, there was a couple running in. Neither of them threw themselves at the ball. It was...
Carsten Smith goes down under the challenge there from Chavez. Looks like it's going to be a potential yellow card for Chavez here, who... being helped up by the referee and then awarded a yellow card.
See, it's an elbow there. It's a forearm.
Yeah, just a flying arm which connects with Smith's face. Rodales gets up, wins a good header there. Popped out this time by Fordyce, gets the ball down and tries to play it in behind the fullback. Niasse challenging Hernandez, got in behind him. It's a good tussle there. And in the end, it's Niasse who concedes the foul.
Paul Miller's just absolutely livid with the officials. He felt that Niasse was impeded by Hernandez earlier in that sequence. They're both fighting for the ball. And then Niasse comes back, wins it. Hernandez wins it back. This is a good battle between two players, though. And there they say Niasse gets an arm around Hernandez there and he gets the foul. But that's just a really good battle between two players. I like that.
Well, Niasse's been involved well in this first half. Referee getting a touch to that one, enough for him to stop play here.
Settle down a little bit. There's a couple of late challenges in that one. where neither connected, which I think is lucky for the players involved. It's getting a little bit feisty out there. And Dave Gantar was just telling everyone just have calm down for a sec.
Smith switching play to the right wing, and he's beating Niasse in the air to that one. Oh, this time he's blocked by Fordyce, and Niasse's away now. Cuts it back to Darryl Fordyce, helps it along there. There's another strike, and this time Ledgerwood doesn't quite get enough of it, and it's an easy stop straight to Fernandez.
But once again, Moises Hernandez putting his team in trouble with another time he's given the ball away. Got to do a better job protecting the ball. Talked about earlier in the half how he's been victimized several times. He hasn't dealt well with the pressure the Eddies are putting on him. That one leads to another scoring chance.
Oteng running that one out. It's going to be a goal kick for Edmonton. Van Oakle largely untroubled, though, in the first half.
No, there was the one ball from Forbes that cut across top of the box that no other OKC player got to. But other than that, there's been no shot on goal. Meanwhile, Daniel Fernandez has had quite a bit to do. He's been very good. The last attempt by Ledgerwood was I'm sure the easiest he's had to deal with was Adam, right at him. But again, a fantastic save on Laudalis that I'm sure we'll see over and over this week.
Giveaway there, though, that's allowed Forbes to get in a good position. Chavez will try and cut this one back. Billy Forbes again is charged down by Rodales. He's won the ball back for FC Edmonton and then gets a free kick. Maybe looking for that one a little bit, but clearly impeded and has a free kick for Edmonton.
Here we see Rodales winning it. Yuma just impeding there. He's saying, I have the right to that position. Rodales is staying down the turf. He hits pretty hard here. A little bit of an elbow up high there. See tonight that Darryl Fordyce is playing 100th game. Albert Watson just celebrated his 100th game for FC Edmonton a couple of weeks ago. Fordyce was hurt on Sunday, but got a nice plaque today from owner Tom Fath before the game.
Yeah, just twisted his knee before Sunday's game and failed a late fitness test, but okay for tonight and back in the fold. That the ball actually traveled a long way in that challenge, that he got the ball, but the free kick given against him. One out of his goal. Watson heading one away, drop drops to Samaras into the area. Smith gets rid of it.
They were really pressing the ball carrier every chance they got. Looks like now teams are conserving energy a bit.
Break by Chavez, and there he has tested Van Oakel for the first time against the run of play, but that's what can happen. A counter-attack. Chavez, a strike picked up well by Van Oakel.
Chavez puts it right at the keeper. A great opportunity, the great run that split the defenders. And right now, Albert Watson, Carson Smith having a bit of a chat about that, about how did Chavez get so open between the two of them that he was able to run right through the gap. And really, FC Edmonton's very, very lucky that Marvin Chavez put the shot right at Matt Van Oakel, and Matt Van Oakel didn't have to move.
Abiobi puts a pass into the path of Fisk at the other end. Fisk on that left flank again. Tried to play in Eckersley, it didn't work out. Got the ball back here, nice control. Rodales takes it a step forward. A switching play for NASL on the right wing. Nicholas forward. NASL is gonna try and go around the outside of Hernandez. Cuts inside of him this time though. And then a left foot strike. Bubbling out for a corner. Corner for FC Edmonton. 3 minutes to halftime.
Sini Niasse steps inside Moises Hernandez. Creates another chance, and he's really been getting the better of that battle between the two players down that wing. Right now, FC Edmonton's got to like that matchup a lot. Niasse's winning a lot of those balls down that side. Getting a lot of chances. That was very smart by Sandy Niasse. He gets a corner kick out of it.
The corner from Eckersley. Watson's up there. It's deflected towards goal, and Fernandez makes the save. Nick Law getting ahead from his first time kick. But Rodales has to intervene at the back to prevent another breakaway there for Rayo. They almost caught Edmonton on the counter.
Chavez was looking, where's the call there? Felt he was pushed over by Rodales. He had a look at Dave Gantar, wondering why he didn't get a call. Dave Gantar felt that was a fair challenge.
McClure down the right wing here. Good sliding challenge there. Sean Nicklaw again on the right wing. It's a good cross. Yamiobi's the target. And has he got another corner? Yes, he has for FC Edmonton.
Daryl Fordyce that time picking a pocket. Taking it away from Boateng. A little bit too common a theme for Rayo OKC in this first half. Players being dispossessed.
This corner from the right. And good goalkeeping again. Juggled it for a little bit, but Fernandez in control there. And it's a good throw out to send away Chavez, who's supported by Samaras. And Billy Forbes is on the right now. He defended well against Forbes there to get it back.
To need three defenders there, make sure to neutralize Forbes' threat. He would have been able to thread that ball through, then they would have had an open shirt in white in front of Matt Van Oakel. The team defending was able to do his job for FC Edmonton.
Yes, he plays a 1-2 with Amiobi, gets back on the end of it. It's an early cross into the penalty area. A chance there for Ledgerwood to run onto it, but it's in the hands of Fernandez again.
Footy Dancel gets very lucky there. plays that ball off his chest. It goes far away from him. Ledgerwood pounces on it. Just that first touch from Ledgerwood. It's too heavy, and it goes to Daniel Fernandez. Danso gets burned there. And again, Rayo OKC been very casual sometimes with their possession.
1 minute of stoppage time at the end of this first half. Nicholas driven a ball to the edge of the penalty area, and Leobi's after it. Eckersley. Niobe touching it to Fisk, getting it back. And they just can't get the shot away before the halftime whistle goes. And FC Edmonton have hit the post, forced a very good save out of Fernandez, and controlled the play. A couple of counter-attacking opportunities for Rayo OKC. But at halftime, no goals. It's 0-0.
Say it was a very good half, I think, for the most part for FC Edmonton. A couple of scares late in the half, but they're gonna look at the chances they created and think we're unlucky not to be up. But Daniel Fernandez said coming back to his hometown and impressing with his goalkeeping in the first half.
We are going to speak to both of the coaches here at halftime. Colin Miller coming up in just a moment, but first we'll hear from the Rayo OKC coach, Gerard Noose. He is down there on the pitch in front of our cameras. We'll hear what he has to say about the first half.
Coach, just maybe your thoughts on the first half.
Hi. Well, I think it's a game that both teams, they want to compete for the 3 points. We're showing that we really care about this game. And, you know, it's quite equal. We're having chances, they're having chances. And I think it's going to be one of those games that both teams, they're gonna need to show everything and take fighting until the last moment just to see who gets the 3 points. So it's an interesting one.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach.
All right.
Well, Gerard Noose from Rayo OKC telling us he thinks it's been a fairly even first half, but his team 0-0 with FC Edmonton so far. The Eddies hitting the post. Fernandez making one terrific save. And so far, though, no goals for Edmonton, although they have had the better of the play in a couple of chances. Coach Colin Miller joining us now. Colin, probably could have been 2 or 3 up. Just tell us how you saw the first half there.
Yeah, I thought very, very bright. Great reaction from Sunday, guys. Great reaction. I'm a bit concerned. We're attacking. It's our corners, and we've set up some of their best chances on a counter-attack. So that's just the defender in me. I'm over the top with that. But goodness me, we've played some good football. We have to be a little bit more patient at times. I think we're maybe in too much of a hurry, but both our wide players have played well. Hussaini Nasi looks in the mood here tonight. Ben Fisk is just, again, a little bit unlucky with a terrific strike. Looks a handful to play against. Tommy Amiobi's given them fits up front there. So we just have to continue to be patient, not give the ball away too easily. And our final ball, that final ball is the one that will make the difference here. You know, we've got into some great areas, and the quality of the cross has been poor. So if we can correct that, continue to get people in the box, we can't be accused of not getting people getting into the box. So if we can do that, I think we'll be fine the second half, as long as we keep the energy levels up, which have been great in that first half.
All right, thanks, Colin.
Thank you.
Coach Colin Miller pretty pleased with what he's seen so far, but still no goals in this match. 0-0 at halftime between FC Edmonton and Rayo OKC. Welcome back to Clarke Stadium. Broadcasting live on Facebook tonight, the North American Soccer League matchup between FC Edmonton and Rayo OKC. And a beautiful night in Edmonton, and always something a little special about a game under the floodlights, as it is tonight. 22 degrees in Edmonton, gorgeous weather, and not a breath of wind. And the players just in a little huddle before the beginning of the second half. FC Edmonton will be attacking the goal to our left. And Fernandez definitely the busier of the goalkeepers in that first half. And they'll be hoping to turn the screw a little bit on him in the second half, Edmonton.
Yes, they will. They're going to be looking to create more chances of that they've had, that they had in the first half, to try to repeat sort of what they have done. I mean, they created a great chance, and Fernandez made a great diving stop off. They've hit the post. So, you know, there's more of it. And I think Colin Miller said, just be a little more patient. Don't rush it. They're creating good pressure.
OKC have got us underway in the second half, attacking the goal to our right, and immediately have conceded a throw-in, which Sean Nickmore will take.
It's been a while since we've had a game under the lights here at Clarke Field. I know we've had a couple of midweek games, but they were earlier in the year when the daylight lasts until about 11 p.m. here.
Yeah, it's been a while.
So I think the cup game against Ottawa, too, was didn't get dark until maybe at the end, near the end.
Nice little step over by Chavez there. That's a bit of class. Goes the ball up to the edge of the box, and Samaras, who is dispossessed. Yuma's had a good game today in defense, the defensive midfield for Rayo. Fans just getting behind the team, trying to give them a boost, beginning of this second half. And there we go, confirmation of the weather conditions. 22 degrees. Very, very nice night in Edmonton.
More like a summer evening rather than a fall evening.
Edmonton having to defend here. So cross flashes across the goal. Chavez again from the right up to Samaras, and just enough presence there from Albert Watson to prevent his route to goal, and it goes behind for a goal kick.
It's a bright start from Oklahoma City, though, that they've Rayo has come out pressed a little bit. Had a good spell of possession early in the second half. Again, both teams played Sunday, but Edmonton didn't have to travel like Rayo did. You just wondered that last 20 minutes of the game how Rayo's legs are going to be.
Chavez looking bright at the moment on the right-hand side. Again, aiming at Samaras, who's going to have to backtrack a little bit if he's going to get to this ball, and he does. Nyasi coming away with it for FC Edmonton, sprinting down that right wing and winning himself a throw-in, takes it quickly as well. Ledgerwood carrying it forward. He's got support from Nyasi. Going to ping a left-footed cross-field pass to Eckersley. Eckersley controls it. Chavez trying to win it back. Clever little 1-2 there. Eckersley now delivering the cross into the area. Not his best. And Boateng brings the ball away. But heavy touch let him down there when he was about to pull the trigger. But they've started much better in the second half. Rayo OKC.
Yes, they have.
Nyasi doing well, chasing back to win that ball. And they're trying to release Amiobi over the top here. He's controlled it well. Looking for some support. There's it from Rodales in the middle.
nasty on Hernandez again, and that time Hernandez was furious that he didn't get a call from our referee tonight, Dave Gantar.
Nasty switching play to the left wing, and Ben Fisk. Fisk cuts in onto his right boot and strikes the shot, and Fernandez saves again. This one straight at him, but Fisk testing him again.
Hit that with power, but right at the keeper. Still, you have to manage that bounce on the turf from a ball that's hit pretty hard. Again, we see Fisk loves to do that, loves to come off the wing and shoot.
Forbes on the left wing, picked out by Menjivar. And here is Richie Menjivar, strikes towards goal there, appealing for a handball. Referee not even considering that.
It's Carson Smith. I think if it does hit his arm, I don't know if he knows much about it. It's hit from very close range. We'll have another look at that, I'm sure.
Sliding tackle by Darryl Fordyce. Referee awards a free kick. Not going to show the card, just telling him to watch that a little bit. Gerard Neuss was quite happy with the way his team played in the first half. Here's the tackle.
Yuma comes onto it. It is late from Darryl Fordyce. He's getting a chat here. Sure, Rayo OKC will be quite aggrieved that the card hasn't come out on that one.
Yeah, I've seen them given for that. I think what saved him there didn't really have the studs up or anything. He was just genuinely a bit late. And it always looks much later on a replay. Fernandez looks like he's going to take some beating tonight. Drives that ball down the middle of the field. Watson heading one away. Fisk again. Loses possession, but they've got a chance to win it back with Ledgerwood. But once again, it's Yuma who's controlled that ball for Rayo. Cross in from the left-hand side. And there's Billy Forbes. A bit of a scramble in there before Boateng strikes it up and over the top of the back.
Oklahoma City's taking a lot more chances now in the second half. We saw they're playing quite compact in the first half, but they're committing more men to the attack in the second half. Looking for those secondary chances, looking for those balls that after the first ball is won, find that to win that second ball and to maybe be able to create something off of that. It's been a bright start for the visitors in the second half.
For Edmonton here with Eckersley. Fisk's touch lets him down a bit there on the left peg. Fordyce has it. Rodales switching it to Eckersley. He's tackled by Chavez. It's a throw in for Edmonton. Going to get to that one on the left wing. It's going to run out of play. Throw in. Danso's just lifted that high into the night sky. Watson nodding it out for a throw in to Rayo. Rhythm going in this second half. There's Forbes again. It's into the penalty area. And it's got thought he'd won his team a corner, but it's going to be another goal kick for Edmonton.
Billy Forbes always a handful when he's got the ball at his feet. He's quick, he turns so fast with the ball at his feet. Got to be aware whenever he's got it. OKC started the first 10 minutes of the second half. They put a lot of, some really good pressure on FC Edmonton. It hasn't resulted in a clear-cut chance on goal, but they've pushed FC Edmonton back quite a bit.
There's Ledgerwood, middle of the park. Chips one up over the top. It's too strong for Niasse.
Not sure if Niasse would have been onside. He got onto that ball, but...
And they're trying to slide it through for Niasse. Just gets deflected back out, and Boateng is racing away with it for Rayo. He's got Forbes to his left. Here is Billy Forbes. Samaras in the middle, but Forbes has crossed. And has gone into the side netting. It's a goal kick for Edmonton.
Edmonton almost got caught there. Fisk tried to thread that ball through for Niasse. He was just trying to play the fine line. Niasse had made a good run. Good deflection, and then Rayo OKC was back off to the races. Edmonton lucky. I think Forbes may have lost his balance a bit as he was trying to shoot that ball. Or sorry, to cross that ball.
Things just not quite coming off at the moment for Edmonton. Rodalas is cross-field pass there, running into touch. Just letting that one run, and Edmonton have it again here with Nick Law. He's gone for the long ball, attempting to thread it over the top, headed away by Danso. Back with Nick Law again on the right wing. Fisk to Eckersley, left wing. Just hear Colin Miller shouting a couple of key phrases, simple and quicker, is what he's saying.
Yeah, definitely. I think they're trying to overthink it a little bit. Just find the open man, move the ball fast. If OKC's pressing with two players in Eckersley like they were there, that means someone, somewhere is open. Gotta be able to find that. Play it quicker.
Here's Christian Rodalas. Just losing possession again there.
Yeah, Edmonton doesn't look quite as crisp as they did in the first half. They're attacking very well and are creating some decent chances. They haven't had that cutting edge chance here in the second half.
Boateng here. Menjivar giving it away though, and Fordyce has the ball. And there's a foul on Ledgerwood. Fordyce trying to take it quickly over the top for Niasse, but referee wants it pulled back because he's going to actually give a yellow card there to Menjiva. Chavez has played quite well, I thought, for Rayo OKC, but he's going to be replaced by Robbie Finley.
Longtime MLS player Robbie Finley, including a stop at Toronto FC. Probably best known to people as a Real Salt Lake player.
Rodales. Very deep free kick. That's not going to trouble anyone. He's just hit that way too strong. It's going to be a goal kick. Still 0-0.
It's a wasted one for FC Edmonton.
Important last 29 minutes of this game.
See if FC Edmonton can find something and find a goal. Or will it be Rayo OKC who forces the issue? Certainly not played at the same pace that first half was, and maybe that's to be expected with the fact that both teams played on Sunday.
Whistle for a handball there against Ledgerwood.
That's a hard thing too. When you have all these games in hand like FC Edmonton does or has on the rest of the league, and people say, you look at it and you think, oh, they're in really good shape in the standings because they're going to make some points up, but finish my point as the goal kick goes. It also means that there's going to be weeks where you're going to be playing three games in a week, and you've got to do it a couple of times, and it's hard to make up those points when you've got the games coming so fast and furious, and you've got to rotate the squad and such. And I tell you, most teams would much rather just have steady a game a week.
And there's the score from the Miami and Carolina match, and Miami continuing their good form, a 1-0 win over Carolina, and they took all 3 points in Edmonton here on Sunday.
Tell you, if Miami makes this charge and that they are towards the fall season and closes the gap, it makes things exceptionally interesting, especially if you're Minnesota United sitting in that fourth spot right now, with Indy already having a spot in the postseason, New York and Edmonton looking pretty good. If Miami comes in, takes the fall season, all of a sudden upsets the apple cart, and Minnesota could be on the outside looking in.
Miami coach Nesta talked to us and seemed very confident that his team could make a push. And they've got another win today, and that's two clean sheets in a row as well for them.
To have, well, lose count of the number of photos I saw on Facebook from people at the Edmonton game who had taken pictures with the great Nesta.
Yeah, fair play to him as well, Steve, sticking around and taking all the requests. That's a class move.
Yep. And before the game, you have to point out Georgios Samaras really spent a lot of time with a lot of people in the Celtic shirts and the Greek national team shirts as well. So being a good ambassador for the league and for his team.
Samaras still out there on the pitch. As Danso plays one up towards Billy Forbes. Yes, he's winning the ball back. Now Watson. Watson's just blasted it forward. Danso heads that one away. Trouble, Matt Van Okel. Colin Miller might be considering possible substitutions. As you mentioned before, the game's got a strong bench, some different options there for him.
He's got Jake Keegan on the bench, he's got Shamit Shoma on the bench. Players that can influence the game. Ben Fisk and Sadie Niasse both done a lot of running, Dustin Perea on the bench as well. You wonder if you might want to freshen that up now, feeling that they've run their race.
Very hard to win that ball back, and now Rodales. Ledgerwood feeding it back to Carsten Smith. Good interception by Rodales there, too.
FC Edmonton, some of these passes, though, they're moving the ball, but then they pass to someone in a lot of trouble. That time the ball went to Ben Fisk with three guys on him. He didn't really have much to do.
Rodales has given that one away to Forbes. Forward to Samaras, back to Billy Forbes. And he's going to try and get on the end of his own ball there, but Van Okel comes out, closes the gap. He may have hurt himself in the process in that clash with Carsten Smith.
See here, I think Billy Forbes just tries to toe poke this past the keeper with the eye that he's going to pick it up on the other side. Actually, it's Carsten Smith who gets the touch. I think in getting the touch, he also gets a little bit of his keeper, but I think it's also the awkwardness of the slide on the turf. Matt Van Okel looks like he's fine. He's already back up. League leader in clean sheets. Really not enough superlatives that you can use to describe the season at Van Okel has had for FC Edmonton. Paul Miller using this break, his chance to draw all those forward players together to give some instructions to them. He's emphatically pointing to the Oklahoma City end of the field and challenging his players to come up with something. They did well to create things in the first half. And really, Daniel Fernandez hasn't been troubled in the second half. So right now, doing some jumping jacks, keeping himself busy.
Smith's ball out of defense intercepted by Rayo. He's back with Forbes again, seeing a lot more of the ball this half. And the cross into the six-yard area. And driven back out for a corner. May have been kept in on that far side as well.
I think it was Moises Hernandez that was up to try to play a dummy. And I tried to dummy that ball through, and it wasn't the right idea.
Edmonton have got away with it with a goal kick there.
This game's really settled down, though. Really not played at nearly the pace of earlier in this match. The FCF have got to dig deep. so do actually Rayo OKC. Both got to find something in this last phase of the game, see if they can turn this thing around.
The stoppage here.
The foul was called on St. Ignacy right there. He was the one that put his foot in, I think, on Boateng there. I think Ignacy may have got the worst of this. Let's see, he kind of comes flying over that tackle. Kind of spun awkwardly.
We're going to see the substitution here, which is Fisk is being replaced by Dustin Correa.
Fisk will have to wait another opportunity to get his first NASL goal. Came awfully close again. And yeah, both wingers. I talked about how wondering if their race had been run, but both wingers coming off and being replaced. Fresh sets on the outside for both on both sides for FC Edmonton as Jake Keegan's going to come in for St. Ignacy. Ignacy can just go off and get treatment and they can bring on someone new.
Next home game coming up is on October the 2nd. Indy 11 in town, one of the teams in the race for the playoffs. 2 p.m. Sunday, and you can get tickets at fcedmonton.com.
Already in, they've won the spring season by a point. Well, actually, a goal difference on New York Cosmos, a point over FC Edmonton. What was a great race for the spring season title. Indy's a very quick team. Team speed to burn.
Niasse's just gone off the pitch on that far side. Keegan is on. Amiobi, amazing run out of defense here. Tackled in the end, but gets his team to just about halfway and has a throw in. Keegan's first touch is not a good one, he's lost possession. Samaras has put a dangerous looking ball in there, and Van Oakel judges it perfectly and makes the claim.
Watson is doing a good job there, shadowing Billy Forbes, not letting him get away.
Backing off a little bit here, FC Edmonton finally. Tackle made.
Hernandez had a big arm around Dustin Correa there, and he gets a little talking to Dave Gantar. I have to say, the referee tonight has been, I'd say, he's really given the players the benefit of the doubt. He's let them play. There's been a lot of talking to's, but not a lot of card. And as long as it's consistent, it's fine. As long as it's the same for both teams, it's fine. I don't mind a referee that would rather leave the cards in the pocket. As long as that's consistent throughout the game, it's fair with everyone. The players look for it. Consistency.
Aniobi, edge of the area here, left-hand side to Eckersley. Now Fordyce into the area. They've got a runner in behind Danso, Correa. Gone out for a throw-in. The crowd really trying to give the team a lift here. Darryl Fordyce again from the left. In comes the cross. Very good header away. Billy Forbes losing great pace there. He's around two players. And he's tackled in the area, and it's very well timed by Watson. And that had to be well timed. Forbes is trying to appeal for a penalty, but looked like a clean tackle.
It did look like a clean tackle, and it was also inside the box.
Could have been. Keegan just getting a good break there from the left-hand side. Cross coming into Correa. It's going to drop for Emiobi. And another great save by Fernandez. So determined not to be beaten, gets down low to his right to deny Emiobi.
Oh, I thought that was in. I think everyone thought that was in except for Daniel Fernandez. That might even be better than the save he made in the first half. He comes flying across, recovering here. Emiobi does well. He picks the side here, and that's just a great save on the stretch.
Eckersley's corner to the far post. Still 0-0. 15 minutes left.
Fernandez, I think, for me right now, is the man of the match. That's a second. I think he may have two candidates for play of the week.
Samaras at the other end picked out with a good ball, but he's driven that one wide. Good chance, but just got a bit of a slice on it. Missed the target.
I think he might have had more time to put this ball down. He had a one-on-one with Adam Eckersley here. And I'm just wondering, Eckersley's on his horse catching up. I wonder if he's maybe trying to play the ball cut across Eckersley. Would have been the right play. Decides to go for goal, and I guess who am I to question a guy who's played that many, who played in the World Cup and how many good years for Celtic.
Hitting the crossbar at the other end is Finlay. Substitute striking one from the edge of the area. Van Oekel may have thought that was over, but bouncing back off the woodwork. Both teams have hit the frame of the goal now.
This game has opened right up. And that shot was deflected by Findlay. The Findlay shot was deflected. I think it came, maybe come off Albert Watson.
Nicklaw chasing down the right-hand side, trying to make the cutback, but it's going to be easy for Rayo. Yeah, really open game now.
Yeah, it looks like both teams are said, I don't want a point, you don't want a point, let's go for it.
Turned by Finlay, beats Eckersley, all ends up there. Menjivar back to Finlay, referee waving play on. Aiming at Billy Forbes, it's going to drop the Boateng. To get the ball back here, and now Smith in field.
I tell you though, last treat to a lot of goalkeeping clinics. I mean, Matt Van Oekel all year long for FC Edmonton has just been outstanding, and we saw Daniel Vega make some very good saves on Sunday, but I think Daniel Fernandez has topped them in terms of the difficulty factor and some of the saves that he's made, at least two of them that he's made today. Emiobi and Rodalis both, I'm sure, thought off the foot that they'd scored.
Yeah, he's had a great game in goal. Fernandez. And, Hernandez, who's had a bit of a rough night, replaced by Van Schaik, comes on for the last 10 minutes, and Shamit Sho replacing Christian Rodalis. Eckersley with the free kick. He's drifted it into the area. Danso gets his head to it. Shamit Schoen with his first touch. Picks up Nick Law. Just chipped that into the mixer. There's the header towards goal. It's a good chance from Albert Watson. He just couldn't keep it down.
Really good ball from Nick Law into the mixer. And you see the frustration on Colin Miller's face. They've come so close so many times, FC Edmonton, but haven't been able to put the finish on it. I tell you, in the way that Daniel Fernandez is playing, you're either going to need to get something extremely fluky or extremely brilliant to beat him.
Yeah, the Eddies have run into two outstanding goalkeepers the last two games. Switching play to the right wing. It's well brought down as well. Watson just went close with that header. Forward again. It's Nick Law. Comes across to the far post. And Finley gets a touch on it, but can't prevent that one from going out for a corner. Deep to the far post. They're appealing for a penalty kick in there, but the foul has been given the other way.
Time is ticking down, and again, New York Cosmos fans watching this and the Cosmos organization, they're thinking this is a good result again. And the Edmonton would basically lose all the game in hand advantage if they don't come up with 3 points. They get a point today, they would be 5 points back with only one game in hand. You know, well, the best you can do is three. So the Cosmos then are feeling pretty good, and they're hosting Edmonton on Saturday. And the Cosmos will be well-rested.
Bit of a frustrating night for the home fans there. You can just see the reaction on their faces. The hope for a goal in these last 7 or so minutes. There will be a couple of stoppages, a couple of injuries in this match, and Finley is down now. Substitution for Rayo, and it's actually Finley's going to come off. He's himself a substitute, but clearly that means that he can't continue, and Gibson is going to replace him.
Finley had a great chance, hit the bar. A shot that was deflected. And Albert Watson there, looks at head to head right away. Dave Gantar is pointing at Boateng, I think. And saying head it right away for both players.
Boateng throwing himself into this challenge. Watson goes up. Oh, but Boateng's elbow hits Watson in the face there. And that's very dangerous.
I gotta tell you, I think that for me that's a sending off. I think Boateng should be off for that. You can't get your arm up like that. I just wonder what the decision's going to be. Dave Gantar points for a foul on Boateng right away. He calls for the benches, but I
yeah, that's very dangerous, going up leading with the elbow like that. And it struck Watson in the head. Head injury is always a very big concern these days. That's why he stopped play instantly.
You see Watson pointing to Boateng down there, and he let him know. See that? Wasn't not too happy.
Well, he's a warrior, Albert Watson, but he still won't have enjoyed that one. So we know about the game on October the 2nd. We already mentioned Indy. And then on the 9th, Tampa Bay Rowdies will be here. 23rd of October. Weather could be anybody's guess what it could be like that day, and that's Jacksonville.
Yeah, you know, normally I would say that that's good for Edmonton, but really the two worst weather games we've had here are the two home losses they've had. At home in Minnesota early in April, and then this Sunday to Miami. See, actually seems to play better when it's warmer and nicer out.
Nice night tonight. They played well. Just ran into a very stubborn team and a very strong goalkeeper for Rayo OKC.
It's interesting here. I see Dave Gantar is talking as Boateng's coming up. It looked like for a second he has his hand in his pocket. So I'm wondering if he is thinking about giving a foul there or giving a card.
Boateng, the Ghanaian player, is the captain of Rayo.
I think in the end he's not going to give anything there, but we call it drop ball. But I got to tell you, that was dangerous from Boateng.
Well, he has shown a yellow card there. Looks like to Samaras.
To me, that was very dangerous play from Boateng. I think the free kick's gone Edmonton's way. As well, it should have. It was a foul on Boateng.
Watson had to leave the field briefly, so the free kick taken by Ledgerwood and then pumped forward by Eckersley. Yeah, Boateng a little bit lucky there, to say the least, I think. On the right-hand side, the cross deflected by Fordyce. He's got the ball back. Ledgerwood sweeping it to Eckersley. Eckersley trying to move in field. Attempting to make the killer pass. He's going to get another bite of the cherry here from the left. Ledgerwood just puts it up there. Headed out wide to the right, but Nicklaw retrieves it. His pass, though, not his best, and it's gone out for a throw-in. Boateng booed by the crowd as he gets back into the play.
He's a lucky boy. I mean, not lucky that he was hurt, but he's lucky, I think, that he's still in this game. Lead with an elbow like that with a leap. You're asking to get sent off.
And making contact.
Yeah, and making solid contact.
Yeah, that was definitely a dangerous attempt at the ball.
Going to be added onto this game.
Eckersley trying to go around the left-hand side. Finds Keegan just with sheer force. Keegan makes a turn and wins a free kick for Edmonton. We're hearing there might be as much as 7 minutes added on in this match because of all the stoppages.
Wouldn't seem unfair to me, actually.
Hey, kick towards the near post. It's headed straight back to him. Not his best delivery, and there are 7 minutes added on. Lifting that into the area, that's going to be easy for Fernandez.
Quality of the final ball still needs to improve for the Eddies. Colin Miller talked about in the first half the crosses that hadn't been good, and it's been a lot of balls thumped into the area that have hit the first defender. We haven't cleared that first defender, and that's a problem. Just got to put defense under more pressure and get a ball to the penalty area.
Nicklow did really well there to bring that ball out of defense and find Shamik Shoma. Now Eckersley on the left, making a charge down the line. Back in field to Shoma. Just tried to play that to the edge of the area, but he's given up possession. Menjivar is away on the left, on the right wing here with a chance to make a cross. Bobbling around in there, and Van Oekel choosing to fist it. Gets a good distance on it outside of his penalty area. Leobi settles it down and finds Fordyce. Correa moving in field from the right, but his ball into the box just goes straight to Fernandez.
Again, another ball in the final third that goes wayward. Doesn't find the intended target. And Fernandez not really in a lot of hurry to get rid of this.
Forbes inside the area. Cleverly playing it off an Eddie's player to win a corner kick for his team. Into the second minute of stoppage time here. Time, but the referee also just making sure things are in order in the penalty box before this corner can happen. Gone right underneath the crossbar and headed it, goal by Samaras, but straight at Matt Van Oekel, in fact by Yuma, straight at Van Oekel. That was almost a chance.
Yes, headed it back towards goal, but Van Oekel right in the right spot. Look what I found as it fell into his chest.
Other end, a good header back to the goalkeeper.
Another frustrating night for FC Edmonton. The second game without a goal.
To now blow the whistle for a pull in the back on Kimura.
As Nick Ledger would. Kimura, former MLS Cup winner. He won the MLS Cup in Toronto when he was with the Colorado Rapids when the game was played in Toronto. I believe that would have been 2010. I was at that game, and it was cold.
Been given a yellow card for time wasting there. Getting the yellow. There's tackle, great lead, but a good catch. Last 2 minutes now of stoppage time. Austin Smith forcing it forward to Eckersley. He's lost the ball. And they conceded the throw as a result. Eckersley trying to win it back, concedes a free kick. Doing well to win the ball there and trying to find Correa on the right. Forced forward by Correa. To win a corner kick, this could be the last action of the match. We're in the last minute of stoppage time. They're throwing everyone forward for this.
Yeah, even. Interesting coming in. You gotta take this in a hurry though. Don't give the referee a chance to blow the whistle. Bring everyone forward, try to create something.
Last chance, Eckersley's corner. Oh, and the header, so close, but deflected over for a goal kick. They're suggesting the deflection came off a Rayo player. It's not going to change the mind of the referee.
Look here, it's a great delivery by Eckersley. And it's Keegan, and I think he has a corner. I think that should have been another corner. I think that came off Woody Danso.
Austin Smith's header seemed definitely to take a deflection from our view. But no corner given, and we're now in the dying seconds of stoppage time. And at any moment now, the referee will blow the whistle.
He'll have Edmonton have one more attack.
There it is. Well, they gave it a good go, but in the end, couldn't get the goal to change things, and it ends up in a 0-0 draw. FC Edmonton with the better of the chances, but running into the supreme goalkeeper tonight, again for the second game in a row, Fernandez with a number of excellent stops, and Edmonton just couldn't find the answer to break the deadlock. We'll hear from both managers coming up in our post-game show. It's 0-0. At Clarke Stadium between FC Edmonton and Rayo OKC. Welcome back to Clarke Stadium. Beautiful night for a game tonight. FC Edmonton just unable to send the fans home with 3 points. A 0-0 draw with Rayo OKC. And a big reason for that, the play of Daniel Fernandez. A couple of top draw saves tonight. We're going to talk to him. He's in front of our cameras on the pitch there. Daniel, thanks for joining us. Just tell us about the game tonight and how you were able to keep Edmonton out back there.
It was a tough game. Just staying focused, nothing else. Two saves I had, and the rest was just defending and staying focused. That's part of the goalkeeper, nothing more. I think the saves they had to be made, and they have to. That's our job, right? If they went in, it was not a good. I wouldn't be happy.
So you were born in this city, grew up in Vancouver. How special was it to have this kind of performance? Do you have family back here still to play in front of?
Yeah, yeah. I grew up right here, like actually right behind the park right here. So yeah, it's special. You know, I love Canada. Did everything for me. Great country, and I'm blessed. Huh? That's all I can say. It's hard sometimes, you know. You hear a lot of things in Portugal, Canada, but I'm blessed and. It's an amazing feeling, huh? Being here, especially right behind right my backyard. So I felt like it was a backyard, so I was taking it like my backyard today.
Well played, Daniel. Thanks for talking to us.
Take care.
What a great story. Just yards away from where he used to live, Daniel Fernandez. getting a clean sheet on his return to the city where he was brought up, and able to get a point for his team, Rayo OKC, which means that FC Edmonton just couldn't force the winner tonight. Let's get reaction from Colin Miller, the Eddies coach. Colin, thanks for joining us. Just your reaction on the game tonight.
Yeah, disappointment. Disappointment. We deserved the 3 points, but we don't put the ball in the back of the net. It's disappointing, but their goalkeeper stood in his head here tonight, so that's a disappointment. I can't fault the players for their attitude and their effort. I was really, really pleased with that. The whole unit, the team was far better than they've been the last couple of games, so I'm pleased with that. And, you know, young Shamit comes on, gives us lots of energy again. So disappointed, it's 2 points dropped, but it's a game that we should have won here. The difference once again here today is a goalkeeper, as it was on Sunday against Miami.
Yeah. Now, you've got a bit of an early start tomorrow in New York. Tell us how you'll approach that one now, Colin.
Yeah, it's we've got to be positive. You know, we're going to the best team in the league, and you know, scoring goals, they're a very dangerous team. If we can stay compact, you know, Minnesota played very well against the Cosmos last week, and with a bit of luck, could have won the game. So we'll stay compact. We know we'll be up against it. It's you know, the best team in the league, as I said earlier. But no fears. We go in there. We've got to be confident. You know, we're playing well. We can't fault the players again, and we're very dangerous away from home, guys. So we have to look to capitalize on the chances that we get in New York. Our luck has deserted us a little bit over the last two or three games, but you make your own luck. We continue to work hard, keep the attitude correct, and hopefully the squad of players that we select here tonight will do the business for us on Saturday.
Okay, good luck. Thank you, Colin.
Thank you.
That's Colin Miller joining us on the pitch, and just a little frustrated and disappointed, I think were his words, that his team just couldn't get the win on another day. Could easily have got this one, and as he said, those have been probably two of the best goalkeeping performances that we've seen here from other teams.
Yeah, and again, I think that Daniel Fernandez said, treated like he was backyard.
Yeah,
said fantastic. Just grew up in the neighborhood. Said just grew up just behind the stadium. So, special story for him tonight.
Yeah, let's talk to the man who's been named man of the match, Tomi Amiobi. He's with us on the pitch there. Tomi, thanks for joining us. Let's just begin with that chance you had that Fernandez saved. Did you think that was going in?
Yeah, I thought it was going to sneak in the bottom corner. But the keeper's got a great hand to it at the end. So we didn't quite take our chances today. I think that's been the story of our last couple of games, especially last game out as well. And I think it came back to haunt us last game, but thankfully we managed to hold on in the end.
Couple of games where you've gone close, the offside decision on Sunday, tonight being denied by Fernandez, and he made a couple of good saves. How are the players feeling just in a spell where you just haven't got over the line where in other games you've been able to?
We're still optimistic. We still know that if we stick to our game plan, we can win games. We've got players that can flip games on their head. And I think the great thing about it is, even though we've been through a bit of a blip these past three, four, five games, we've only lost one game. So we're still picking up points, and we're only looking up the table.
Great. Well, good luck in New York, Tomi.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for joining us. That's Tomi Amiobi down on the pitch. And as he said, thought he got the goal there. I'm sure we'll see that in our highlights as we look back at the game tonight. The full-time highlights brought to you by Oodle News.
I think the highlights might be the Daniel Fernandez show. He certainly was very, very good today. First to see the goalpost, helps him out early in the match.
Yeah, the one time he was beaten, came back off the upright.
Yeah, Ben Fisk with a great chance. And here we see this great save on Christian Rodales. He sees it late. A strong hand. Tomi Amiobi said he got a great hand to his shot. And you see him stopping Amiobi there. Similar with reaching out with that big paw of his. As he said, it was very, very special for him. Special night for him to be playing. And there we see the deflection. I think it was off Albert Watson from Finley, and it goes off the bar. But getting back to, it's a great story. Not one FC Edmonton love, but a kid from the neighborhood coming back to Edmonton and putting up a clean sheet against FC Edmonton. Special feeling for Daniel Fernandez.
Yep, 0-0 it ends tonight. And there's the Tomi Amiobi and some of the other players on the pitch talking to the supporters. The league standings still looking pretty good for FC Edmonton. They would have liked to have been 2 points closer to New York. That's the fall standings and where They're in that fight with the Miami. But when you look at the combined in second place and 4 points behind New York, three clear of Indy. So still a pretty good position. It's going to be a big game for them on Saturday.
They need to get some kind of result now just to kind of recover a bit. They haven't scored in a couple of games, and Jimmy Marr is not a bad goalie himself. So another test for the Eddies.
Home games coming up for FC Edmonton. First, they've got to get New York out of the way, but then Indy in town on Sunday, October the 2nd, 2 p.m. kickoff for that one. And we'll be back here at Clarke Stadium to see how the Eddies can do that day. That's how it started tonight. Daryl Fordyce presented with a plaque by the Eddies owner, Tom Pfaff, making his 100th appearance for the club tonight. And he went close there very early on in the game. Fisk hit the post. And then after that, Fernandez made some very good saves for his team. That one, probably the best one, at full stretch from Christian Rodales. And then later on from Tomi Amiobi, denying him two. And so the hometown kid comes home and gets a point for Rayo. Thanks for joining our broadcast tonight. It ends 0-0.